lot of people here are aspiring entrepreneurs, and I heard some questions about, you know, how do you get investments. So I thought I'll share a bit about my own journey of how we started T-Box and, you know, some of our own learnings along the way. I heard Atul's talk about, you know, data 2.0 and the worlds merging between technology and biology, whereas I come from a world which is literally minus 5.0. If you ever, if any one of you has ever been on a tea plantation, you might even realize that if you ever find one single desktop computer, that's a very progressive plantation. So things in my world are very, very different. My talk today is all about looking at the same old industry in a very, very new way. Just to give everyone an idea, this is what a view looks like 45 minutes from my home. If I take my car from where I come, and I come from a very small town called Siliguri, if you drive down 45 minutes up in the hills, this is the view. And you know what's the view I get? What do I do in 45 minutes in Bangalore? I'm still stuck between Sony signal and Wipro signal. So that's the kind of reality I have to sometimes, you know, adjust compared to where I come and where I am today. I grew up in a tea plantation, literally. You know, my family has been involved in the tea industry for almost a century. When I grew up, almost every weekend I was in the tea plantations, and you see all the workers in the tea plantation, it felt like they were magicians, you know, who were, for a, say, a 6 or 8 year old kid, who were converting or using some sort of magic to convert this very small looking green leaf to a drink which we all cherish. You know, at that point of time, I had no idea one day I'll come back to the tea industry. Fast forward, did my undergrad in Singapore, was working as a corporate finance guy, and one day I come across this New York Times article which says, you know, while the whole world is going through recession, or there's literally boom, you know, doom everywhere, a lot of things in India are exciting. On the spur of the moment, quit my job in Singapore, came back to India. And naturally, when I come back to India to look at entrepreneurial opportunities, the first industry I look into was tea. Very, 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 very specific, but I don't know how many of you, I'm sure all of you drink tea, but I don't know if most of you know that by the time you get your teas from the plantations or from the producers who makes the tea to your home, be it in India, Singapore, London, New York, it's literally 12 to 24 months, if not more. And by that time you are drinking your tea, if you ask me, you should not even be drinking those kind of tea. So our simple logic was, if we can disintermediate the entire supply chain, really make sure that we get you the teas directly from source, and we are the only intermediary there. That was pretty much our thesis of starting T-Box. Very, very interesting slide. You know, I don't know how many of you would have seen this movie. I see some hands there, but this was a very famous movie by Wes Anderson called Darjeeling Limited. Very interesting coincidence. When we started our first business, it used to be called Darjeeling Tea Express. And at that point of time, we had no money. So the only way we were able to get customers was very smartly put Darjeeling Limited in all our blogs, newsletters, email articles. And Google was also very new at that point of time. So very, very quickly, we were able to kind of scale up the Darjeeling tea market. Very unlikely coincidence, but that really helped us. Another very interesting insight, which is very important for us, you will never have your fruits and vegetables more than, say, at max 2 or 3 days old, right? Because you know after that, it's not even worth having. Why is it that today you're having your tea, which is also an agriculture product, which is also grown on the fields by the farmers, why is it that you're having it 6, 12, 18, 24 months in some cases? Because no one tells you so. So next time, if you are going to buy teas, even if it is more than a month old, and I'm assuming many of you will, many of the manufacturers won't even tell the date of manufacturing, but it is extremely important for you to ensure that you get fresh products. So this is what the state of the tea industry looked like. You know, you are getting teas which is coming from places like this, where during the rainy season, in monsoons, there's rains everywhere, there are rats, and all things which are minus 2.2. We looked at those things and we said, you know, why not do things differently? Why not do India's first cold chain processing so that before you get your teas, it's stored at -5 degrees, which, by the way, not even the Tatas or the Levers have that. And fortunately, along the way, we have been very lucky to get covered by CNN, Forbes, you know, New York Times, as was mentioned earlier. But very, very importantly, two gentlemen whose pictures you see on the screen. The gentleman to your left, or rather, yeah, to your left is a customer of ours, you know, who later we realized turns out to be a founder of a $180 billion private equity company called Oak Hill Capital, who eventually invested in us. And right side, you have someone who is known to everyone in the audience, but who also owns the world's second largest tea company called Tata Tea. So it's been a six-year journey, and I'm going to keep it very short. Six-year journey, we have shipped about 1 billion cups to 117 countries. So far, we have been online. Thank you. We have been mostly online, but we have just gone offline with our first store in Bangalore at the Bangalore airport. So next time you are going out of the city and you're taking an airline, please be sure to visit us at T-Box store at the Bangalore airport. And that's been our short journey. Thank you so much.